Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone. Introduce, my name is Geraldine Nuraini from the 2020 Digital Office Administration Study Program. I am a seventh semester student who has run an independent campus certified internship program. I would like to thank Mr. Pujiwahono as the supervisor who has helped me in completing the internship report project. On this occasion, I will present the result of the internship report that I have made. The title I made is Fieldwork Practice Report on the Finance Division at DNP Indonesia Corporation. As for the point that I start with in chapter number 1 is introduction. Chapter number 2 is overview of street vendor. Chapter number 3 is internship, and the last chapter number 4 is closing. Okay, let's go into the discussion of the chapter number 1 is introduction. Before entering into the main discussion, it would be nice for you to know the background of the internship. The first, improving digital office administration student in terms of quality, which include knowledge, abilities, and experience through the Merdeka Campus Certified Internship Program. In the era of the Industrial Revolution 4.0 towards the era of Society 5.0, the 5.0 era requires the younger generation, especially those who carry out knowledge in tertiary institutions, to be creative, innovative, and solutive to problems that occur in society and the world of work. This is because many sophisticated technologies are used by every field of work, which means students must be able to adapt and be technologically literate. The second, obtain graduation from fulfilling the final assignment for the fieldwork practice courses, which has been carried out by Diploma for Digital Office Administration Study Program student. And the last, the third, train time management skill at work, establish good communication relationship, efficient finance, compile file in the form of soft copy and hard copy are more organized in accordance with the existing archive storage system. Okay, next slide is a slide that explains place and time of the internship. I did an internship at PT DNP Indonesia, which is located at Pulgadung Street number 16. To 18 Kavling 2 Hat 2 and 2 Hat 3, Pulogadung Industrial Estate, Jakarta. The internship starts from August 1st, December 29, 2023, with a time schedule from Monday to Friday. Is 8 a.m. to 15 p.m. On the next slide, I will explain the activity process that I have done. Starting at the preparation stage, including seeking and contacting companies, submitting and receiving apprenticeship application file, and participating in apprenticeship outreach, replies email from the company to the overview via coupon, and carrying out internship. The third stage in reporting, in which the practitioner makes and conduct apprenticeship duties. Next, I will provide an overview of the internship venues from chapter number 2. In the first sub-chapter, I will explain to company profile. DNP Indonesia Corporation is most comprehensive plastic and paper packaging printing company and has a good sales reputation in the Asia-Pacific region by taking advantage of technological advance in every year. The history of this company is that formerly DNP Indonesia Corporation had a company name, namely Dai Nippon Gitakaya Printing Corporation, located at Ceylon Street, Pasar Baru, Central Jakarta. In collaboration with Roda Mas Corporation in 1972, this flexible packaging printing company was founded with the intention, the purpose of investing foreign capital in accordance with law number 1 of 1967, which operate in the realm of offset and gravure, which was built in Jakarta with the notary deed of R.M. Suroejo SH number 55, dated April 22, 1971. Then, due to change in the replacement notary deed, finally, the company changed its name, and the government also proposed to establish the DNP Indonesia Corporation and move its location on February 9, 1987, and Jalan N. Pulau Gadung Street, Kavling 2, Blok H, number 223M, Pulau Gadung Industrial Area, East Jakarta until now. DNP Indonesia Corporation produce various types packaging product according to customer order or make to order with a sales and purchase corporation contract system. This company has a vision, namely to run its business by utilizing advanced technology, but that in currently developing so that all product produced are perfecting in terms of quality, thus it can position itself as the number one supervisor and high quality packaging printing company, and is recognized in the Asia Pacific region to foreign countries. Meanwhile, its mission is to serve various can of needs related to packaging printing need by all level of society, by keeping up with the times that produce high quality product at service. In addition, it is consistent to fulfill its responsibility to society or corporate social responsibility when running its business. This company culture consists of several points, namely, the first, customer and community life, include upholding trustworthiness and honesty with customer or customer, providing excellent service to customer or customer, and last, providing product that are of interest to customer or customer. The second, taiwa. It's a taiwa, communication or dialogue, include enhancing the development of transparency, creating active conversation, and maintaining responsive talk patterns. And the third, partnership and independence, including meaning harmonious relation with the scope of the same division and other related division, and be personally professional and high responsibility towards your mandate on or work. Therefore, spirit and fighting spirit facing challenge, including manage time well, prioritizing the implementation of an important and good thing. Understand the condition in every reform in society. Dare to do something now or work Avantok in its risk. Be proactive and don't complain easily. And the last, openness and honesty, including have an open, honest, passionate, and trustworthy personality. Act honestly according to the law and social ethic, preserving the surrounding environment and making a good contribution to society. And the last, striving to always make the community put their trust rightfully. PT DNP Indonesia Corporation, it is company that has a well-organized organizational structure, starting from the highest position to the lowest position or division, all of which are close related to each other in the company. Operational process. This image is the organized structure of the DNP Indonesia Corporation in the finance section, which is where our practitioner carries out the internship, especially in the part of the table marked with the position of the practitioner, namely in the account receivable collector and finance section. The next discussion is about the company line of business. The company is engaged in printing and product packaging. The printing technique used are divided into two, namely paper-based offset printing. Process activity include pre-printing, offset printing, financing offset printing. The second technique is rotogravure printing, which use plastic material. The activity process start with plastic media being laminated on rolls with sticky glue, edging or drying. Processing of plastic rolls to cutting rolls using a slitter machine. Following are some example of packaging product by DNP Indonesia Corporation. With a subchapter, namely the era of war. Namely the era of work that are the responsibility of carrying out the internship. First, the field of finance, which include work such as making invoice receipt by utilizing Microsoft Excel and printer, controlling the data list on document and attachment that must be appropriate, affixing date stamp and signature to document that have been received by collector and finance account receivable. Make incoming finance report using the AX system, or commonly called finance and operation, and make financial expenditure report that are local or rupiah, and import or foreign currency using Microsoft Excel, and confirm the status of invoice using the application RepCan. Furthermore, the field of work related to correspondence, namely counting and sending a letter via email when sending document to the company and collect invoice that are passed to. Third, the field of office automation, which include work namely printing document, scanning document, and duplicating document by utilizing photocopier and printer and scanner. Fourth, namely the field of filing, which include the working of filing invoice receipt, proof of payment, taxpayer identification number, letter memos, and other documents. In carrying out receiving invoice receipt, the practitioner carries out the stage, include the first, practice getting acknowledgement of receipt of invoice from the work that has been done previously, namely checking and affixing a signature, then the attachment are set aside from the white and blue attachment. The second, practice grouping or sorting invoice receipt based on the year they were received is on the GNE sheet. The third, practitioner sorting invoice receipt based on that and amount received. Documents are sorted with the yields that at the top or according to the employee order and the odds that at the bottom. And the fourth, after finishing sorting the document, the practitioner allows order and start transferring invoice receipt to the ordinary according to the position that have been arranged. Then provide a description of each ordinary on the index card print on the form of the ordinary. Practice giving information on the date, amount, and year of document in each example in each order. And the last, when finished, the practitioner return ordinary to the filing cabinet. In the filing mixed document, the method is almost the same, but the difference is that the practitioner does sorting all document based on the AX or the count code for each document. After that, practice sorting by taking their AX from behind, then placing the youngest number at the bottom and the oldest number at the top. If the customer sort it by placing the date of the earliest document below. Fifth, the practitioner does work related to the secretarial field, namely receiving calls from internal and external company. The check that the practitioner does include. Sub number one, providing paper or a book to record color message and holding writing instrument using the right hand. Number two, pick up the phone using your left hand and when the ringtone sound 2 to 3 times. Number three, say greeting such as good morning, good afternoon, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Is not hello. Number four, introducing yourself, that part or division, and the company of origin, accompanied by a sentence offering assistance such as Witiara Finance Dain Indonesia Corporation. The 50. Number five, if the caller want to talk to the employee in question, they practice connecting to the extension by pressing the recall, then pressing the call. And the last, when finished, practice closing again by greeting and putting down the receiver after the caller disconnect the phone. The next discussion is about the obstacle faced by the practitioner when carrying out the internship. The constraints faced are two factors which include external constraints. First, archive storage system is not well organized, in which the archive documents are not well organized and are not based on the stack in filing document, such as there is no special paper gap as a code or marker for each invoice receipt, letter, memos, and envelope. This situation is supported by the placement of document types out of place, because when the practitioner is carrying out the process of compiling the archive guide, encountering archive, whether in the form of letter, taxpayer identification number, memos that are out of place, often then file are mixed with one other in one order, or which the practitioner memo mentioned in the section that there are mixed document in one place. Due to employee discipline in returning archive, which is still low. Furthermore, the second obstacle regarding telephone handling procedure is not implementation properly accompanied by telephone etiquette in the office. In carrying out field work practice, internship often overhear conversation of employees around them when on the phone, but not according to proper procedure and ethics, such as number one, employees say the greeting hello to the other person of the phone in a less friendly tone. Number two, does not introduce the address of the company and where the employee work, but both when calling and receiving. And number three, talking while cooking. Number four, emotional or angry when on the phone, because often the call is a nuisance. And number five, using words that are critical but not accompanied by an apology before or after. Number six, using the telephone for personal again. Number seven, ending the conversation without greeting. And last, put down the receiver quickly or in a hurry and not slowly. Okay, when there are obstacles, the practitioner takes the initiative to provide a solution to the problem in the question. On achieving issue, the practitioner carries out the stage in correct filing, including the first, practitioner carries out active to control the completeness of each archive. Number two, next, the practitioner index the archive and provides the classification code. Number three, then the practitioner makes a list of archive classification, which is used as a good gap for making the letter codes contained in the index card. For example, the practitioner wants to make a list of archive classification with the main problem. Include text sub-issue. A. Payment and sub-issue is A. Sub-issue of A is number one, billing. Number two, settlement. Then practice creating letter codes such as PG.A.1. And number four, the practitioner also makes cross point card for document that have a relationship with other document. Number five, the next step, the practitioner begin to classify or resort the file based on the subject and that system, according to document criteria that are easy to retrieve. Number six, practitioner giving gets or paper divider taken from the subproblem of each archive, then specifying them into subproblem. And the last, the final step is to save the archive into the ordner. In addition, the practitioner design a dynamic archive application. It's connect to the internet, which aims as a step to minimize problems that often occur in archive, such as damage, loss, hard to find. In the second obstacle, namely telephone handling, the practitioner used the role model to be a good and correct example regarding work matters that are not in accordance with existing rules or procedure. Practitioner become a role model, which means directly implementing telephone procedure in accordance with good Indonesian language rules when receiving phone call in a friendly manner and not getting angry at the call, hoping that the employees around will hear the step that the practitioner used when receiving a telephone call. Apart from that, as a means of education, the practitioner make media in the form of poster, in which there is education regarding procedure and ethic in handling telephone. This poster will be affixed to the information board in the section. Student find gap between knowledge and skill, such as student pay attention to how employees work when filing document that is only by entering document into order without paying attention to the procedure that have been learned in lecture, and student pay attention to how employees work when handling incoming calls, phone calls that are not based on procedure and ethic in a good and correct office. Meanwhile, the practitioner gains knowledge during lecture about telephone procedure according to the rules. Okay. Next, during this internship, the practitioner has made several contributions to the finance section, which include the first, progress and receiving income budget fund more quickly because the practitioner takes the initiative and concerted when doing the work of collecting receivable from customer using invoice through the TradeSafe portal, especially in expect condition such as the mentor practitioner had an accident while using a motorbike to go to the company. Practitioner have full responsibility in assisting his work. Namely, payment collection. Practice using good time management by paying attention to the time limit for sending invoice with the time they were sent, so that no invoice are built up and no money are rejected. If an invoice is rejected, then the practitioner immediately resolve the problem to the accounting or communicate through the message menu available on the portal. The second, archive documents are better organized and there is no accumulation of archive. This is because the practitioner archive documents on all ordner up to the index sheet, which is usually placed in the form ordner. Practitioner design himself using micro support so that it looks neater and more attractive. The third, the practicum provide knowledge about the actual naming of office equipment because employees do not know the term office equipment, such as paper punch become a perforator, a paper shredder become a paper shredder, small white paper clip become paper clip, notes become sticky notes, staples become stapler, small black paper clip to binder clip, filing cabinet to file cabinet, and so on. The fourth, efficient finance, there be reducing the workload of each employee in the section. The fifth, the practicum teach employees several ways to use menu in Microsoft Office, is Microsoft Word and Microsoft Excel, in addition notifying website that are useful for facilitating some office work, such as website for converting document. And the last, practitioner help in solving some of the problem that occur when doing invoice, talk the portal or sending directly, by coordinating with parties in the accounting or sales department. The last explanation in chapter number 4 is concludes the discussion of the material. Based on the description that the practitioner met in this fieldwork practice report, the following conclusion can be obtained. Number 1, practitioner get a division field that is not in accordance with the cursus measure, but the practitioner gets a job that is in accordance with the work of an administration secretary. Number 2, practitioner can implement the knowledge obtained during college. Number 3, practitioner can understand the working of employees in the finance so as to add insight into the various type of work that employees do. Number 4, the IMDKM or Independence Campus Certified Internship program provide many opportunities for practitioners to focus and deepen their understanding of each field of work because it is estimated that the implementation of street vendor lasts quite a long time and adapt to other employees. And the fifth or the last, talk street vendor, the practitioner become a person who is more initiative, creative, responsible, disciplined, ability, skill, and ability to adapt and build new relationship. Practitioner provide recommendation for economics and corporation faculties. In particular, the Faculty of Economics is highly expect to provide the best service facilities for students, hold comparative study program both to museum archive and to various company, and to organize or contribute all students to make part in competition according to their major. Meanwhile, recommendation for the DMP Indonesia Corporation include: the first, company shall provide explanation and direction regarding the overall process of implementing trade vendor in the section. The second, companies add advice to have a digital archive storage system. Number 3, companies are advised to be upon the to student doing trade vendor to receive suggestion or criticism. And last, the company provides trade vendor certificate to practitioner. The following is a bibliography is site source that the practitioner took for the purpose of making report. The figure show that practitioner has carried out an internship at the Indonesia Corporation. That's all from my presentation. Sorry if there are mistakes in word or pronunciation. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.